Kilinor, the magical world of RuneScape. It's divided into chunks for easy use. Welcome to Chunkman Dead Die Kill, the series where I conquer the landmass of Kilinor by doing tasks and unlocking chunks. Last episode, we completed 4 more tasks for 4 more chunks. These tasks were completing 3 quests, being Rag and Bone Man Part 1, A Porcine of Interest, and Fairy Tale Part 1. And the last task was completing the Lumbridge and Drainer Easy Diary. Our map expanded with the western part of the Karazi Jungle, the Fight Arena, the Tower of Life, and lastly the easternmost part of the Wilderness on the third level. Today we start off where we finished last episode, just after completing the Fairy Tale Part 1 quest. Before we do anything else, we're going to unlock the fairy rings. So we'll have to start the quest of Fairy Tale Part 2 without having the Herblore requirement. We're a few levels off, I think 8 levels. So we can't actually finish the quest, but we can finish the quest up until the point we get fairy rings. And that's just going to be too good for the account not to do it. So let's talk to Martin again to start the quest. So we gave Martin an update on what we did on Fairy Tale Part 1, so that we cured the queen by killing Tanglefoot, and now he wants to just check if that's true, that everything's back alright. So he says he's going to plant some crops and we have to talk to him in a few minutes. Apparently the problem isn't solved, everything's still dying, and even faster than before. So let's see in Xanaris what's the matter. We're back in the room where the fairy queen was being treated, but everything seems to be destroyed over here. Also, no notion of the fairy queen or fairy nuff which was treating the fairy queen. So let's see what this is. There's a lot of letters here we cannot read on the back end of the nuff certificate we picked up. Let's look for some clues. We're here at the cosmic altar. Let's read the sign over here, which has the same kind of signs. Maybe the fairy godfather will know what is going wrong. The fairy godfather says that there are not enough people for a search party, and that the fairy queen has probably been abducted through the fairy rings. We can talk to a coordinator to let us know how the fairy rings work. Let's try and configure the fairy ring here. The combination should be AIR. Right. This is still in our chunks. I didn't think about this. But either way, this is the fairy rings unlocked. And now we pretty much have a good amount of fairy rings, like here to the Legends Guild, that's a pretty good one. The Wizard's Tower has one as well. Over here, DIS. We can have one to the desert, there's even two. So this is pretty much a massive unlock for the account. But either way, for the rest of the quest we probably cannot teleport to these parts. I don't think we will have those unlocked yet, so we will have to stop the quest here. But either way, we got what we wanted, we got the access to the fairy rings. The next quest is going to be the Tower of Life. First of all, we need to unlock the chunk. And then, because we just have the fairy rings unlocked, let's just use them to show how useful they are. So, we need to go to DJP. And there we go, right next to the quest start. Let's talk to Effigy to start the quest. Effigy here is the owner of the tower here, but it's still under construction and the construction workers don't really want to finish the tower because it's a bit weird. So we are going to check to solve that issue. Let's talk to Bonafido here, the head builder. Bonafido has no intention of going back into the tower and finish the work because of all the weird things, and he wants an explanation. And we talked to him and said if we could check inside, but he said only builders are allowed inside, so we have to get a builder's outfit. Let's talk to Black Eye here for the helmet. We got the hard hat after a small quiz. Now for No Fingers, he doesn't want to give us the boots he has extra, so we're just going to pickpocket them. Okay, that's the builder boots. Now let's talk to the guns. For the price of a beer, we got the builder's shirt. Now we just need the trousers. So let's check some of the bushes here. Yep. There we go, that's the full outfit. Now to get in. After a small quiz on the mentality of a builder, Bonafido lets us in. Let's see what we need to fix. Let's maybe take some supplies before we go up. First up is the pressure machine to fix. Now we just need to make sure there is enough pressure and there are no leaks. So this is a fairly easy puzzle. There we go. That's the first machine fixed. Next up is the pipe machine. This is also going to be a fairly easy puzzle. There we go. That's the pipe machine fixed as well. Now for the last part, the cage. And we get another puzzle. And that's the cage complete. So everything's in working order now. Let's go and tell Effigy. After we told Effigy that the tower is now complete, he wasn't really listening anymore and he just went up with his fellow alchemists. So let's see what they are up to. They seem to be creating something. They created a homunculus. The alchemists ran away from the homunculus, so let's go back down and talk to them. Apparently, we will have to talk to the homunculus and to see if we can calm it down, because the alchemists are too afraid to do it themselves. The creature has been made with magic and logic and is pretty much confused, so we will have to guide him to either magic or logic. So, with a few questions, this should be fixed in no time. The homunculus has gotten its thoughts in order and now he wants to scare the alchemists for creating him. And there we go, the homunculus scared the alchemists here. The alchemists ran away after some explaining of what they did, and the homunculus went to the basement of the building. This was where Gutix created a lot of creatures, and let's talk to the homunculus to finish the quest. And that's the end of the quest. We get 2 quest points, 1000 construction experience, 500 crafting experience and 500 thieving experience. And maybe the most important thing here, the access to the creature creation, which is combining 2 creatures to make a monster, and then they drop quite a lot of things, so that's going to be useful in the long run. But because we finished the Tower of Life, that's a task we can complete on our spreadsheet, and then a chunk to unlock. The quest, the Tower of Life, our 45th quest, has been completed for 141 chunks in total now. And then back to the map. The last chunk we unlocked was the fight arena. So getting to the Trinome village, the monastery, the Yanil chunk would all be great. But let's see what the chunk picker has in store for us. Pick a chunk. Okay, more water. Let's try that again. Pick a chunk. Okay, nothingness. Getting more of those lately. Third time's the charm. Pick a chunk. And we get the left side of the Ferox Enclave. But it is the wilderness, so not that interesting. But we still have a lot of quests to do, so this is fine. With completing the Tower of Life, we're pretty close to the fight arena. So let's unlock that chunk we got a few chunks ago. And go to Lady Serval to start the quest. Apparently her son and husband has been kidnapped by the General Khazard here and taken to the fight arena to fight. The reason for this was because General Khazard wanted the hand of Lady Serval, but she refused multiple times. So let's see what we can do about this. To get into the fighting arena, we need some armor to be like these Khazard guards. So that's the helmet and the armor. And there we go, we're in. Let's talk to this guard to know where they are. He wants a drink. So there's a pub here in the same chunk. Let's talk to the barman to get a beer. The Kali brew is so strong, you'd better lie down before you drink it, as it makes you collapse. We didn't even need to steal the keys from this guy, he just gave them to us if we mentioned that we will take care of the prisoners for him. Now we have the son here, Sammy Serval. Let's use the keys to try and free him. And that's Justin, the husband, but there is an ogre, so we'll have to save him. And there goes the ogre. The general made a deal with us. We just need to fight some more battles, and if we survive, he will let us all free. On to the fight with the Khazard Scorpion. Okay, that was a really easy battle. And now for the third battle, we get a hellhound named Bouncer. And that Bouncer down. General Khazard is not really happy, but he did promise us to let the 2 Serval people go if we kept on fighting. So he just let them go, but he wants to kill us, so let's just run away. Now to tell Lady Serval the good news that her son and her husband has been released. And that's the end of the quest. We get 2 quest points, 12,000 attack experience, 2,000 thieving experience and 1,000 coins as a reward. So That's another quest complete, so that's another task we can check off on our spreadsheet and then pick another chunk. Another fast quest, the fight arena, has been completed. Our 46th quest already, and we have 142 chunks as well. And then back to the map. Last chunk we unlocked was the left side of the Ferox Enclave, and pretty much doesn't change much for the other chunks we can unlock. So let's see what the chunk picker decides for us. Pick a chunk. Okay, more water. Let's try that again. Pick a chunk. More darkness, okay. For the second time in a row, the third chunk is the charm. Pick a chunk. Or not. Okay, more water. I'm getting really close to Apatol though. Fourth one, pick a chunk. And we get the Mauritania farm patch. And now I'm not really sure. I know this is used in the animal magnetism quest, but I don't know if we have everything else we need for the quest. But that might be a really, really good chunk to unlock. If we look at the quest helper, what we need, I immediately see here the 20 ecto tokens, which is going to be gotten here at the Ectofantus. So I think we need both. So here's the ladder. Yeah, we're going to need both of these chunks as well to do animal magnetism. But we can already unlock this one for the new farm patch. So that's not going to be the quest we'll be doing now. Next up is the Prince Ali rescue. So we finally don't have to pay those 10 GP each time we want to go from Lumbridge to Olcarid. And to start the quest, let's talk to Hassan here in the Olcarid Palace. Okay, apparently Hassan is just the money guy. We need to go see Osman to get the actual task. Osman here tells us that the prince has been kidnapped by a smart woman and some stupid guards. So he wants us to make a disguise for the prince to look like the woman if we incapacitate her, and then get the prince out dressed like her, then everything should be fine for the prison break. So let's head over to the Drainer village. We also need a wig for the prince, so we can talk to Ned here, the person in Drainer that makes ropes, to make a wig for us. Okay, that's the wig, but it's still in the color of the balls of wool, so let's dye it yellow. Next up, we need to make the same skin color as the woman we're going to tie up. So let's talk to Aggie for something. And there we go, that's the skin paste. Here we are at the jail. So these are the guards here. And this is Lady Kelly, the woman which is the mastermind. With some trickery and some flattery, we got the key print from the key around her neck. So now we just need to make a brand new key. Let's go back to Osman for that. Okay, Osman got the key print and the bronze bar, and that was apparently enough to give the key to his daughter Lila back in Drainer. So time to go meet up with her. So we got the key from Lila here, and now the only thing we need to do is get rid of the guard inside the prison, and then tie up the mastermind. So let's talk to Joe to see if he likes some beer like most people here in Gillenor. We got him drunk, so he's not going to be a problem anymore. And now we can just tie up Lady Kelly here. Now to free the prince and give him all the items to dress up as Lady Kelly. And this already gives us the option to pass through the Alcaret toll gate for free because we are a friend of Alcaret, because we saved the prince. So that's already the biggest part of the reward. And now let's finish the quest by talking to Hassan, the money man in the palace. There we go, that's the end of the quest. We get 3 quest points, 700 coins, and of course the most important one, the free use of the Alcaret tollgate. That's the quest complete, so that's another task complete and another chunk to pick. After the Drainer Village chunk, we've been cruising through the quests. That was Prince Ali Rescue, our 47th quest completed for 143 chunks in total. Back to our map. Last chunk we unlocked was the Mauritania farming patch. So we're getting closer to the Ectophantus and Port Phasmatis, which will be a great unlock. But let's see what the chunk picker thinks we should go and do. Pick a chunk. Okay, a water chunk. Let's try that again. Pick a chunk. Ooh. The bottom part of Mayor Ditch. As long as we don't have Burg de Rot unlocked by doing the Mairiki questline. So we need to unlock pretty much these 3 chunks before we can do that. Mayor Ditch isn't possible to do without those. So for the moment that's not going to be that useful, but of course we are going to have to need it for later. So let's just continue with our quests. That's going to be all for this episode. We've gotten some really nice quality of life unlocks with, on the one side, the fairy rings, and on the other side, we finally don't have to kill goblins when we forget our cache at the Alcaret gate. Next week we will continue with the last quest from the Drainer chunk, but it will be a very important one. So as always, I hope to see you next week.